Welcome to worship, friends and family at LCC. I'm so grateful to be with you for worship through this digital means. Awesome to have the band and the tech team and Pastor Megan here. So grateful for all of you and your worship leadership. Hope whatever's going on in your day is blessed. Please know that God is with you wherever you are in your journey of faith. Whatever doubts or convictions you have, whatever struggles or joys you're living with, God is there in the midst of it all. As we begin our worship, let us remember that God is blessed. Blessed be the Holy Trinity, one God whose steadfast love is everlasting, whose faithfulness endures from generation to generation. Amen. Trusting in the mercy of God, let us confess our sin. Reconciling God, we confess that we do not trust your abundance and we deny your presence in our lives. We place our hope in ourselves and rely on our own efforts. We fail to believe that you provide enough for all. We abuse your good creation for our own benefit. We fear difference and do not welcome others as you have welcomed us. We sin in thought, word, and deed. By your grace, forgive us. Through your love, renew us, and in your Spirit, lead us, so that we may live and serve you in newness of life. Amen. Beloved of God, by the radical abundance of divine mercy, we have peace with God through Christ Jesus, through whom we have obtained grace upon grace. Our sins are forgiven. Let us live now in hope, for hope does not disappoint, because God's love has been poured into our hearts through the Holy Spirit. Amen. Let's join together and pray as one. Teach us, dear Lord, trust in your steadfastness, to find your peace in the midst of fear, your hope in the midst of loss, your compassion in the midst of all that seeks to discourage and divide. Empowered by your eternal gift of grace, may we be servants of your will and join our hearts to you as we work for the healing of the world. Amen. This time we invite all the children watching and worshiping to gather together for a children's message from Pastor Megan. Let's sing together as they get in place.
For our children's sermon today, I went on a little field trip. When I was at Concordia, I took care of a lot of critters. And in our gospel story today, Jesus talks about sparrows, about the smallest little critters, and he says that he takes care of all of us, even down to the littlest of critters. So I want to show you some critters today. And we can be thinking about how is Jesus taking care of each of these animals. So come on, let's go. So this beautiful lady is Jewel. Hi, Jewel. How are you? Yeah. And we can see that she doesn't seem particularly worried about anything. She's pretty chill and just kind of hanging out. Right? She doesn't know me. She doesn't remember me. But, she's kind of taken care of here, and she's just sitting in the sun, and Yeah, you are. And Jewel is a reminder of that God is taking care of us, right? Even if we don't see it. There's more critters in there. Anybody in there? You guys can see all these critter habitats. There's a little frog. You see the little frog? He's just hanging out. He's not too worried about life. You guys can see some little cockroaches here. I know some people are really freaked out by them, but I kind of like their whiskers. And they're just chilling. They're not really worried about anything except going back to bed. And these guys are super cool. These are walking sticks. They're just kind of chilling, doing their walking stick thing. They like to eat salad. And this is Stat. He is a fat-tailed gecko. And I think he's a great example of how Jesus says we don't need to be afraid. Because he's just kind of chilling. He's just doing his gecko thing. Just hanging out on my hand here. God is taking care of him. Just as God is taking care of all of us, wherever we are. We don't need to be afraid. Because Christ is with all of us, even down to the littlest of creatures, like Stat, like Jewel, like the frog we just saw. God will always be with us.
Hey kids, back in my office, now that I'm not surrounded by creature heaven, I thought I would sit down and we could pray together. So let's pray. Loving and gracious God, thank you for all the creatures in our life, from our pets at home to the birds that sing outside our window, to the tiniest little ants that walk across our path that remind us of your love, of your constant, steadfast presence with us. When we hear the song of the birds, or we hear the barking of dogs, or we see animals celebrating life all around us, may we too be encouraged to know that there's not a moment when you won't walk beside us, and you are ever guiding us. You care for every feather on the body of a sparrow and every hair on our heads. You know us completely, and we give you thanks for your love. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Thanks for coming with me on the field trip, guys. Many thanks to Concordia College's biology department for their help with this project. So, yeah, thanks, guys. See you next week. Bye.
The Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Jesus said to the 12, "A disciple is not above the teacher, nor a slave above the master. It is enough for the disciple to be like the teacher, and the slave like the master. If they have called the master of the house Beelzebub, how much more will they malign those of his household? So have no fear of them, for nothing is covered up that will not be uncovered, and nothing secret that will not become known. What I say to you in the dark, tell in the light. What you hear whispered, proclaim from the housetops. Do not fear those who kill the body but cannot kill the soul. Rather fear him who can destroy both body and soul in hell. Are not two sparrows sold for a penny? Yet not one of them will fall to the ground apart from your Father. And even the hairs of your head are all counted. So do not be afraid, for you are of more value than the sparrows. Therefore, everyone therefore who acknowledges me before others, I will acknowledge before my Father in heaven. But whoever denies me before others, I will also deny before my Father in heaven. Do not think that I have come to bring peace to the earth. I have not come to bring peace, but a sword. For I have come to set a man against his father, a daughter against her mother, a daughter-in-law against her mother-in-law. One's foes will be members of one's own household. Whoever loves father or mother more than me is not worthy of me. And whoever loves son or daughter more than me is not worthy of me. And whoever does not take up the cross and follow me is not worthy of me. Those who find their life will lose it, and those who lose their life for my sake will find it." The Gospel of our Lord. Praise to you, O Christ. Hello, everyone. Welcome to worship, wherever you happen to be watching or listening to this week. I want to get started by having you think about a tough decision you've had to make. What's one of the hardest decisions you've ever had to make? one that you had to ponder for a really long time. Maybe you kind of lost sleep over it, or, you know, maybe you went around to your friends or your neighbors or your colleagues and asked them for some advice. Maybe you read books about it. Maybe even after you made the decision, you were still wondering if you'd made the right call. I've been feeling this way a lot as we continue to journey through these strange times we're living in. And in Greek, I actually looked up Greek this week. Pretty big deal for me. In Greek, this word is called distazo, or literally it means trying to go two ways at once, shifting back and forth. No solid ground, no firmness beneath your feet. Literally having your feet in two different places with a divide between them, pulling you apart. And with how we're living right now, even with COVID cases going down, there's still so much unknown, isn't there? There's still so many things that are pulling us apart. So many questions in our mind. You know, how are we going to make sense of the last 4 months? How are our kids doing? Is it okay to travel again? Is it safe to go get a haircut? Oh, I know I need one. How are we going to celebrate summer? How are we going to celebrate anything? How will the fall look? That's a big one. How will the fall look? So my feet have been trying to stand in a bunch of different places. I don't know about you, but this has been an ongoing issue for me. Wavering, doubting, hesitating between different realities. And it's into this state of in-between, of having our feet spread apart and feeling unsteady, that we have this strange, powerful gospel section for the day. So Jesus is still preaching to his disciples. He's still sending them out. And into the midst of this, this sending, he gives this part of his sermon. And I kind of like to, I think it's very fitting we're doing this on Father's Day, the week of Father's Day, because it's kind of like the ultimate dad speech in my mind. Every time my stepdad or my dad have ever given me a speech about anything, it's sort of been this way, where it's like chestnuts of wisdom, but they're not completely related. So it's sort of your job to put them all together and figure out the inner meaning behind them. So this, maybe we could call it Jesus' dad speech. And Jesus, in the midst of our feeling like we have this reality or this reality, Jesus offers us something really extraordinary. He offers us both and. In the midst of our distasis, distazo, he commands us to think anew about how we live in the midst of times of uncertainty and fear and worry. And Jesus pulls together a lot of different opposites throughout this part of his sermon. He talks about how we are both broken and whole. We may feel like we're in charge, like we're the masters, but we're meant to be the servants. We may feel fear and deep uncertainty in our lives, but in the midst of that, he brings this peace. Do not be afraid, he says. He talks about how we are but bodies, but we are also eternal souls. And we need not fear anything on earth because of the eternal nature of our soul. He brings together all of these things that should be opposites. But to Jesus, they're not. They're all wrapped up together as one. And the truth is, the world would love to convince us that it's possible to be either or people. But as Christians, we are called to both and. Jesus says that this lie that the world wants us to believe in the black and the white, in the whole or the broken, either saint or sinner, forgiven or lost, in conflict or at peace. The either or mindset perpetually will lead us into this illusion that we're deficient, that we're at a deficit, that we can make everything perfect if we only have a little bit more money or a little bit more time or a little bit more strength. If we work just a little bit more, 40 hours, 50 hours, 60 hours a week, everything we dreamed would be within our grasp. That because if you're not perfect, you must be a mess. If you're not working, you must be lazy. If you're not young, you must not have a credible voice. If you're not an elder, you must not know what you're talking about. These are all lies that the world seems to push upon us, that we carry within us, that cause this distazo that haunts the deepest parts of our hearts and causes conflict within and around us. But in this gospel passage, Jesus spreads wide his hands and he offers us something else. He offers us the center to pull our legs back from wherever we've been sliding over these last however many months and to come back to him, to what only he can offer. Because while the world wants us to believe that we are perpetually deficient in Christ, that is just not our reality. In Christ, because of who Christ is, we can find peace in the midst of fear. We can feel valued and cherished and share that value and deep love with others because he did it first. And he says that this kind of living, this way of living in the both and kind of mindset, it does cause division. It can even tear families apart because there are people who won't understand, how we can see the good in other people that others just want to write off, how we can be champions for grace and forgiveness when it's so much easier to hate and divide, how we can have hope even in the midst of overwhelming uncertainty. But we know that living and loving like Jesus, it doesn't mean that life will be perfect or easy or even pain-free. But by keeping our eyes on Christ, on he who is our center, we are empowered to see his love in the ordinary, to see the sacred in the ordinary, to see the heavenly in the earthy, to be at peace in the midst of fear, to have hope in the midst of despair, to hold all of these things together and to call them life. So that's why that's so powerful, right? When he says, "Do not be afraid, for you are of value." He knows every hair on our heads, just as he knows every feather on the body of the sparrows and all the creatures that we saw during the children's sermon. This is a wild journey of life, but it is one that we will ever and always walk with Christ by our side. So wherever this message finds you today, whatever distazo you feel is slowly pulling your feet apart, hear the words of Christ this day, to step back into our center, into the love that brings heaven to earth and declares that God's kingdom is for the peacemakers, for the poor in spirit, for the mourning, the sick, the merciful, the hungry. God's kingdom and purpose is for just such a time as this, just such hearts as these. Do not be afraid, for Jesus is in the midst of all life. Be still and know he is with you. Thanks be to God. Amen.
And no.
this time in our service, we regularly collect an offering, and we just want to say thank you for all of the gifts that you have contributed to support the mission of LCC, for signing up for Simply Giving, for mailing in checks, for your cards of support, for the sharing of your amazing gifts of music. Thank you for supporting the mission of the church. We can't do this alone. Called into unity with one another and the whole creation. Let us pray for our shared world. Expansive God, you bring diverse voices together to form your church. Open our hearts and unstop our ears to learn from one another, that differences might not overshadow our baptismal unity. Providing God, your creation shows us that life comes from death. Renew the places where our land, air, and waterways have been ill for too long. Direct the work of all who care for birds and their habitats. Protecting God, sustain and keep safe all who work to defend others across the world. Revive and strengthen organizations dedicated to caring for refugees and migrants while their homelands struggle for peace. God, in your mercy. Loving God, you promise to be with all who are persecuted for your sake. Guide all who speak your word of justice and console any who are tormented or targeted for being who they are. Compassionate God, you are with us and we are never alone. Bless all fathers and father figures who strive to love and nurture as you do. Comfort all who long to be fathers, and all for whom this day is difficult. God, we lift to you those in this community who long for your healing care and peace. We lift to you Marlis Peterson, Carol Steenerson, Marty Simmons, Nancy Lee, Nikki Peterson, Michael Allard, Kay Schoenbeck, Dave Buck, Susan Stefanowitz, Leroy James, Amy Simmons, Dan Garretts, Ron and Edie Broughton, Mike Post, Larry Otterson, and Vivian Schroeder. We call upon you to comfort those mourning the death of Trisha Kemper, Margaret Peverini, Shirley Baumbach, and Hudson Luchtemeyer. Receive these prayers, O God, and those too deep for our words, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Lord, remember us in your kingdom and teach us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Just a couple of announcements in the life of the church. We'll have outdoor worship on the church lawn again on Wednesday, June 24th at 5:45 p.m. and on Sunday, June 28th at 10 a.m. Bring a chair with you. We hope there isn't a 90-mile-an-hour wind. Fingers are crossed. You never know around here. Song sheets and worship materials will be available on our website. So if you join us for outdoor worship, we hope you make yourselves, avail yourselves of those resources. And happy Father's Day to all those papas out there and papas-to-be. And I hope that you're all celebrating fathers in your life. And congrats. receive the blessing. God the Creator, Jesus the Christ, and the Holy Spirit, our Comforter, bless you and keep you in eternal love. Amen. Let's sing. Jesus. Thanks be to God.